What's going on, YouTube? Today we have another edition of an FRL rip. This is already going into week 5, which is crazy. It's just flying by. Well, today we're going to face off against our good buddy, an amazing YouTuber. I'll let him introduce himself right now.
How's it? So welcome to my Monday Night Football rips.
Now that you're back, you can see that we've got and decided to go again in back-to-back weeks with Absolute Football. This is a dual thing because I'm also looking for some possible of our guy, our quarterback, Baker Mayfield autograph or rookie cards. Obviously, you can get some Lambjack. Josh Allen seems to be on a roll as well this year, so it might be somebody to look out for. But we had terrible luck last time, if you remember. If you watched my last one, I'll post it up here. Our autograph and our memorabilia card were not usable. There are some other parallels that come with like a glitter finish as well. But there are tons of little things that we can get. There are different autographs in here. Some cool inserts. I'm hoping that we have a chance to do that. As you can see, I've posted this again. Just really quick rundown. Base cards are times one. Parallels are times two. Numbered cards times three. Relics, mems times four. A bookend, one or one of 99 or 99 of 99 is times five. Autograph times six. If we get a jersey number, like we did with the Pat Mahomes in week one, that is times seven. And the coveted one of one is times 10. So what I'm going to do is rip this and then I'll cut away, or maybe I'll end this video and then the next video tomorrow will be me picking my team. So let's take a look and see how we're going to do against our opponent. And I'll do a breakdown, a rundown of how we did last week in the next video as well, to show you our record and what worked, what didn't work. So we get four packs, 10 cards per pack, two hits are guaranteed. Well, it says on average. Can never guarantee anything. Put that back there. We got our four packs. This looks like our mem card. And this one looks like our auto. I made that up. But both those are a little thicker. Okay, better luck than last week. Let's go. Greg Olsen, he is still playing, so that's a good thing for tight end. Jonathan Stewart is not. So we'll put him up top because he's not going to be able to be used. Case Keenum, backup for the Browns. Jimmy G, at the time of filming this, was still kind of hurt, so I'm not really confident in that play. We got Tyreek Hill, which is a really good wide receiver. Alex Collins, no good. Chris Hogan, no good. Keenan Allen, this one is one of the parallels. And we got our first hit, it looks like. So that'll be a good one. A parallel is times two. Put him in the wide receiver pile. And our first hit looks like it will help us. It's not who we want, obviously, but a defense for Cincinnati, which I don't know. I know that's probably a bad choice as well. But this would give us times six, so this will be something that we'll have to think about. We got a Revolutionaries and Mr. Barry Sanders. That's a cool insert. So let me sleeve up our hit real quick. Like I said, it's not the greatest, but it will give us a chance to possibly use it since it is a defense. All right, pack number two. Still looking to see if maybe we can get. This is a great defensive player. That'll work. Put him down here for now. Alex Smith, still currently not playing. Melvin Gordon, who's got a new team over Denver, has been doing pretty well, actually. So we'll put him in the usable running back position. Same thing with Gurley, new team, but still doing well. Sean McCoy, probably not. Golden Tate is an option. Bobby Wagner, so it gives us another good defensive player. Then we got Greg Olsen again. This one is the parallel. Okay, cool. So this one's got that little glitter there. So that would give us a times two on a tight end spot. This is a rookie finally in Kurt Benkert. It's a different name. Sam Darnold, introductions, also a rookie card, but hasn't been doing too hot. Sort of lacking in the quarterback, but he's our only choice so far, I think. All right, T.Y. Hilton, another wide receiver. David Johnson gives us another running back. Devontae Parker, another wide receiver option. Le'Veon Bell, hurt. Jarvis Landry for the Browns. That's a hit right there. Alshon Jeffrey. Jimmy Graham gives us another tight end to look at. Marcus Mariota, still not playing. Got a rookie in Darren Payne. So that gives us possibly another defense. Ooh, this is that Diggs play, right? Against the Saints. That's cool. I like that. Stephon Diggs, another wide receiver option. Not sure if this is a holo or a prism, or if this is just the insert as it is. It's definitely like holographic. I'd probably say it's just normal insert, but okay, so our last hit should be here. Honestly, we needed a quarterback. Right now, I think we're sitting on Sam Darnold only, which is not good. Jacoby Brissett is not going to be the guy. Either is Chris Thompson. You got another Keenan Allen. Ooh, we got a really good defensive player in Aaron Darnold now. Zay Jones, probably not going to use. Alvin Kamara, good running back option. Where did I put all the running backs? Oh, mixing stuff up, I think. There we go. Jameis Winston. Unfortunately, he's not going to do it. Alex McGowell. No. Well, we got our hit. Is this Isabella? No, Christian Kirk. I'm not upset with Christian Kirk as a hit. He would be a good wide receiver. I mean, he's not getting as much looks this year because they got Hopkins now and some other decent options, but a times was at four on a mem card. That'll definitely be something we look at. Here we got a two-punch of Dak Prescott and Zeke. I'll have to ask about this, but if I could use that, that'd be nice. One or the other on that card. Well, I think this box was much, much better because we can use our big hits, but we are really lacking in the quarterback. We have Sam Darnold and possibly Dak. Obviously, we want to use Dak there. But we do have some tight ends that are playing, not like great tight ends any longer, but definitely with get a times two on Greg Olsen, I'll take it. We did get Aaron Darnold and JJ and Bobby. Actually, all three of these are really good options as a defensive player in place of the kicker. Alvin Kamara's, all of our running backs are good choices. Two-way players can make wide receiver receptions. Or wide receiver reception. Can make receptions out of the backfield. I think Christian Kirk is definitely a strong run in the running there. And we got a Keenan Allen I think we had something to work with. Well, it's going to come down to this right here. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun. Missed out on Baker again, but pretty clean rip. I like this rip. This one was definitely much better than the first one. All right, guys, see ya. What's going on, YouTube? All right, so today, maybe this is an extension of the rip. I just did a rip of some 2018 Absolute Mega Box. I am not sure if I'm adding this onto the last video or if I'm making this a separate video. So if it's the same video, welcome back. If it's a new video, welcome back. But this is week five, of the Fantasy Rip League. Currently, I might be playing our boy over at Folk Rips. He's the Eagles fan, and he might be on a bye this week. If he's on a bye, I might be playing Debuff Man. So I will have a cutaway here to introduce whoever I'm playing once they figure that out. But as you remember, okay, we ripped that. The base cards are times one. We'll just do a quick rundown. Parallels are times two. Number cards times three. Relics or mints are times four. Bookends, that is a serial number of like 1 of 99 or 99 of 99, also known as eBay 1 of 1s, is times 5. An autograph is times 6. If you're lucky enough to get a jersey number, like I did in week 1, that is times 7. And the coveted 1 of 1s are times 10. Okay, so this was a bit of a rough pick, I have to say, because we were pretty slim in a couple and some spots, but we're going to try and make this work. I'm going to start over here with the defense because I think that'll be a little more straightforward. I was thinking about playing Bobby Wagner or Seattle's defense just because I feel like they're pretty active and they can always come up with some picks or something like that. But I decided to go with the Rams and Aaron Darnold. I think that that's a better and a safer play this week because I think they're playing Washington, and Washington tends to turn the ball over quite a bit. That coming from, you know, Dwayne Haskins being a second year QB, and they just got a lot of young talent over there. So I think that the Rams defense could come up with some picks there. As far as the kicker, we didn't get a kicker, so we're going to have to use a defensive player. As you can see, I got J.J. Watt that I was thinking about playing, but we did pull an auto in the defensive spot. I thought about playing Cincinnati in our defense, but they are playing Baltimore. I just don't feel like a time six on some negative points is going to be very beneficial. I don't believe that he's a starting linebacker, but I think he's going to get in the game. He's projected to get like 2.5 points. So I think the safer play is just to pick him, even if he gets nothing. The safer play is just to play him as the player instead of, you know, if he does get in the game and gets, you know, 5 points, that's a pretty big bonus. Now, when we were looking at our wide receivers, we had quite a few wide receivers. We had lots to choose from. Tyreek Hill was a really good choice. Alshon Jeffrey. We got our boy Jarvis Landry. He just threw a touchdown in the last game. I think that's a good one. Stephon Diggs. Obviously, here he's on Minnesota, but he's with Buffalo. He's having a crazy year with Josh Allen. But I decided to go with our mem card first. Arizona's been killing it. You know, being really active. Kirk hasn't really had the breakout year that people are expecting, but I'm hoping that he gets things going. I know that Hopkins gets a lot of the looks and stuff like that. And Kyler Murray sort of had like a down game or two. So I'm thinking that maybe Kirk could be the guy. We get a times four on that mem. And the other position was pretty easy. We got ourselves Keenan Allen. Since this is a parallel, I'm going to take this Keenan Allen times two. This guy's obviously really talented, especially now that he's got Herbert back there throwing to him. So I'm going to go with Keenan Allen with the times two. So we got a times six, times two, and times four. Not too shabby. Now, the tight end position, we only had two people to choose from. We had Jimmy Graham and Mr. Greg Olsen. I'm going with the times two on this Greg Olsen. Neither one of these guys, I don't think, are really great choices. But Greg Olsen could, you know, sneak a touchdown from the MVP candidate up there. With Seattle, so I'm going to go with him, and hopefully he gets a touchdown. We get some times two action on that. Keep the parallels alive. The running backs, we were pretty solid on running backs. We had quite a few to choose from. I had David Johnson here, who's okay, but things are kind of hectic down where he's at now with Houston, so I'm not sure what's going on. I decided to go with a guy who's had a really hot hand this year. And Alvin Kamara, who seems to be getting multiple touchdowns a game. He's been like their workhorse. He does it both with his hands and both with his feet. So I'm going to go with Alvin Kamara, even though there's no parallel. Next, we got the other running back position. Le'Veon Bell's actually coming back this week off of IR for the Jets. I'm not sure how much action he's going to be seeing. He might be on like a snap count, especially since he's come back from an injury. So I decided that I'm going to pass on him. Melvin Gordon's actually been doing really well for the Broncos. I just don't like their matchup this week, so I decided to actually go with Todd Gurley. He's down there with Atlanta now. He's been getting a lot of action. Similar to his year last year with the Rams, like he doesn't seem like he's getting tons and tons of carries. They're like kind of limiting him that in that aspect. But when he gets to the goal line, like he's the guy that's getting the ball, and he can always sneak in one or two touchdowns. Plus, he's got good hands, so I like the play there. I think I got two strong running backs, even though they're just times one. Now, the rough part here is the quarterback position. Okay, I didn't have much to choose from. I had a ton of backups, if you remember. And I only had a couple of starters. Our starters are Garoppolo, Sam Darnold, and I'm not sure about this card. I'll have to see if they'll accept it. I hope they do. But it's Dak Prescott with this two punch. The only reason why I'm hoping they accept it is because I don't think either one of these guys are playing. Garoppolo is now questionable, but he's missed the last couple games, and I'm not expecting him to play in this game either. So far, he hasn't taken any of the snaps, so chances of him playing are probably pretty slim. He's had that ankle injury, so I think he might sit. And then also Sam Darnold has a shoulder injury, and they're talking about Joe Flacco actually starting over there with the Jets, and which leaves me pretty thin. I mean, if I'm hoping that I can play Dak, because if I can't play Dak, I don't have a quarterback. If not, then hopefully one of these guys play and I'll substitute one of those before game time. I'm hoping Jimmy G just gets his ankle right and he's able to play, or if Sam Darnold could go with a shoulder injury, I'm not sure. But that does it. I'll have to see who I'm playing. If I'm playing Folk, there might be a bet on the line. We'll see. If I'm not playing Folk, DeBuffman, we're probably just playing straight up. Because someone has to take a bye this week since we have odd number. But yeah, that's the team. I hope I do well. I need to get back in the win column. Right now I'm 1-2. So yeah, we need to win badly. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next one.